esprit tout diva, je me perds dans tes yeux, je me noie dans la
I never really sit outside, but I should more. One of the reasons I'm doing the whole I wanna watch every sunset thing. Because I wanna go outside more. Yesterday I hung out with my friend Rod. I love the noises of the birds. And all the little noises of the forest and being outside, it makes you feel like you're never really alone if you're in nature. Also, my nose is really stuffy. That's why I sound good. And a half to four. Not a really good time. Rod and I have a lot in common. And we both like poetry, and he showed me music, and we went on walks, and we talked about stuff, and it was a very nice time. Most of them, I kept pointing things out, like perfect spots would be cool for being outside, and then I realized that I have spots like that in my own house that I could go and be outside, so I'm gonna start being outside. Anyways, look at my view. Pretty, I know. Anyways. The reason I wanted to make another video is because I wanted to talk about oh, I just swallowed phlegm. His name was Snowball. Okay, listen, I know how stupid Snowball sounds as a name, but there's context, and I'm gonna give it to you. So, Snowball, is a call sign for this guy that I met at, I meet him, aviation camp. I'm trying to put my arm in the blanket because I'm cold. I live in Florida and it's like 70 to something degrees. I met Snowball the last day of that summer camp. Met him the last day because we were in different like groups. I forgot all of the terminology. Mine was the vigilantes. His, I forgot what his was. I barely remember his face. So the last day of the aviation camp, we had a mission. For this mission, we had to like trek around in the forest for 2 hours. The counselors were like fake bad guys. Like there was this, like, it was kind of just like a capture the object type game, but it was like military style. I got captured by one of the counselors, so I had to go in like this small fenced in area, like really small actually. There were lots of kids in there, and that's not where I met him, but that's where I was. And I was interviewing people with my phone. I was saying things like I'll insert some audio from it here.
Kansas, I'm a news reporter. Is there anything that you would like to say to the people about this mission?
My rib cage hurts like a laid on spiky rocks for the past 30 minutes. Army crawled all the way down this
I know why we won.
I don't know. I'm moving. To be honest, I feel a little like crying, and I don't really know why. This isn't to the people of the world. This is... I'm not talking to myself. We don't... I'm talking to myself, but to my phone.
That's it. Why do you feel like crying?
I don't know. I just feel a little like crying. I'm not sad. Well, I guess I am sad, because like, you get to know a bunch of people for like a week, and then you never really see them again.
I mean, you could see each other again.
That's true.
It's a very faint possibility.
Very faint possibility.
Mm-hmm. We can follow each other on social media and have fun.
Yeah, that's
about all we can do. Mm-hmm. If I'm ever in wherever you live in Florida, I'll say, yo, airhead. lunch. And you'll say, yes, sir. Because you will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if I'm in... Shoot! Man... It starts with an M, and it's by New Jersey and New York.
Maryland.
And if I'm near Maryland, I'll be like, yo, what's up, Cornflake? Let's go! And we'll go on a little adventure.
That's exactly what we're
doing. Yeah.
Then we were released because I don't remember even what happened because it was like late at night, it was dark, and I didn't really know what was going on. So I don't know why, but we were released and we started walking back to camp, maybe because time was up or we won or we lost. But either way, I was heading back to camp with everybody in an airplane. We were heading back to camp with everybody and I hear this song. I remember! It was like, birds, 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 bird out of the woods. It's from that movie. The like cover had a helmet on it. I'll insert it here. But I heard that song, and so I went over to who was playing the song, and I just started dancing because they were dancing. Started dancing, and then I introduced myself, and we talked a little bit on our walk back. We just instantly clicked. It's like two people that just like. Understood each other. We barely knew each other, but like we had the same type of vibes. I know that it's like Phoenix, you know nothing about them. Jeez, I didn't really know anything about it. But then we got back and we had to start lining up after our like conversation and like little dancing, getting to know each other. We were like in the movies type scenario. And we hugged and we were like, probably never gonna see or talk to you again. He said, I don't know, or something like that. We hugged and then my team was like, ooh, Phoenix, we're bringing guys. And I was like, 5 seconds ago, guys, calm down. We got in our lines and we prayed for graduation. And blah 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 blah, whatever happened the rest of the night, and then fast forward the morning, I asked if I could go say bye to the guys in my group. I said, try to say bye to the girls. I think they I felt bad waking them up. I see them filing out of the room because the counselor took me upstairs to them. Hamburger, cornflake, gutter, Kansas, etc., etc. And then out comes Snowball. It was just like the perfect end to a person that I will never meet again. I shook hands with all of them and then I left to go home. I don't know if I'll ever see a lot of those people ever again, especially Snowball, because I don't have his number or anything. But I just think that it's like kind of crazy to have like a momentary connection with someone. I guess it's all like the connections in life really are, you know? Like one of my best friends, she defriended me recently, and though it hurt like hell, it wasn't her defending me out of anger, madness, or bad intentions. She just didn't want to be my friend anymore. And yeah, it sucked, but it helped prove this whole point that the majority of the relationships that you have in life are momentary, and they teach you something, and you let them go. You can keep a part of it as a memory to remember the lesson and remember all of the good times, because those are what stay with you forever. But people, they just don't. You know? Squirrel on a tree. Like, funny, like a little monkey. Why aren't squirrels considered monkeys? That's my question. So yeah, that's today's sunset story. Thanks for learning about my good old pal Snowball. Catch you on the flip side.
Ciao.